the Asian Development Bank approves a $200 million loan to the Philippines to support the most impacted by COVID-19. With us now for more is Ahmed Saeed, Vice President for East Asia, Southeast Asia, and Pacific at the ADB. Good to see you, Saeed. Welcome back to the program.
Thank you, and good morning, Kathy. Very good to be back with you.
Right, so talk to us about the significance of this latest loan support approved on April 27th, worth $200 million.
Well, this program is really about helping support the poorest and most vulnerable communities in the Philippines get through the enhanced quarantine measures and the social isolation measures that we know are absolutely essential for the health response to the COVID-19 pandemic. The $200 million are going to top up existing programs that the ADB has already been involved with, the 4Ps program, for over 10 years, and is going to support as many as 18 million people. As you know, the central challenge in this crisis is that the very things that we need to do to fight the disease also affect the livelihoods of the poorest and most vulnerable segments of our society the most. And this $200 million is directly focused on addressing that negative impact on the most vulnerable.
And that negative impact includes the transition process of being able to get back to recovery as we try to save lives?
Well, the ADB is certainly involved in that process. The $200 million involved in this specific loan is really a cash transfer program just so that people have money in their pockets so they're able to buy food, they're able to pay for medicines. There's a much broader set of things that we're going to need to do as the country begins to transition back to some semblance of new normal. And the ADB is engaged on that front as well, both in terms of helping the country expand its testing capacity, which will be critical to monitoring that process, in terms of designing economic programs that can help the country flourish in what will be a very new and very difficult economic environment.
So what are the terms of the latest loan of $200 million, the duration and interest rates?
So this is, typical concessional lending from the ADB, very similar in structure, although much longer in tenor, to the $1.5 billion CIPRO that we provided just a few weeks ago.
And this loan aligns with the $1.5 billion approved on April 23rd, but how exactly does it work in connection to that earlier loan on April 23rd?
Well, this year, 2020, the $1.5 billion loan, the $200 million loan, and the remaining program of engagement we have with the Philippines, this is going to be our most significant year from a monetary perspective in terms of work we're doing with the Philippines since the ADB began over 50 years ago. The $200 million, as I mentioned, is very targeted on direct cash transfer assistance to the most vulnerable elements of Filipino society. The $1.5 billion loan that we provided earlier is a budget support instrument that's designed to support the whole of government COVID response, and in particular, the $12 billion COVID-specific response that the government is making.
How are you assessing the poverty levels and poverty incidents now in the Philippines as Metro Manila and other areas live out the seventh week of the enhanced community quarantine? Do you think it's gotten a lot worse for the underprivileged and the most impacted, the vulnerable?
You know, I think it's very unfortunate, but the answer to that question has to be yes. It has to be an absolute yes. It's been necessary. It's been essential that the government do what it did in order to protect the health of the population. But these steps were taken knowing that they came at enormous cost. You know, this is a country that's made really significant strides against in the fight against poverty, moving from 25% poverty levels across the population a little bit over a decade ago to 16-17% now. Our view is that there's 14 million people in the Philippines who are at risk of sliding back into poverty. That situation is very similar to what we see elsewhere in the region, in the world. And the reality is, as we open up, as we need to and as we should, in a graduated and cautious manner, these people who are vulnerable are going to confront a regional and global economic environment that's simply not as supportive as the one before this crisis. You know, the new world we're going to enter, it's going to be a poorer world. The core engines of global growth will be burning more slowly. Globalization is challenged. So it's an enormously daunting and enormously significant and important challenge to make sure that the poorer elements of society, the more vulnerable elements of society, many of those who just started to emerge from great need and want, that these segments of society are protected and given opportunities to improve their livelihoods as we move forward.
Just a final point, Saeed. The ADB is also preparing an expanded social assistance project to support the Philippine government's medium-term financing of the 4Ps program. What sort of timeline are we looking at for this one?
So this is a $500 million loan that'll be going to our board early next month. It's very, very closely linked, actually, to this loan. If we look at this loan and we look at how quickly money has been dispersed to needy populations, you know, those who have bank accounts and who are registered with us under the 4P program, 98% of those groups have already received funding. If we look at the groups that don't have bank accounts and that weren't registered, to date, only 14% of those people have received funding. And so we see that this gap in terms of, you know, data on the lists of poor people, it's essentially, you know, really drives how quickly they can get funding and how well the government is able to audit what it's doing. So with this program, we're going to be looking to extend our lists of poor people. And I think very, very importantly, we're going to be looking to see what are the best practices, for example, in fintech solutions, in order to provide these cash transfers to everybody who needs them, whether they're in the formal economy or in the informal economy.
Now, talk to us about those best practices. What have you found out so far?
Well, I think we look at what the government has done to date, and it's done some really interesting things. So if we look, for example, at the very important wage subsidy that the government introduced for smaller businesses, they have an online app to allow businesses that are BIR and SSS registered in order to access it. That's been a very, very successful initiative. 200,000 businesses were pre-qualified under that program. Over 100,000 workers have received advanced wages. So these sorts of solutions are very powerful. Mobile-enabled solutions for cash transfer, we've seen in certain other countries, have been very, very powerful. So there's a good ecosystem of potential solutions that can be used and that we'll be collaborating with the government in order to explore that I think can significantly enhance our ability to identify and reach these needy populations. One thing we all know is that the importance of a robust social safety net, something that many have emphasized for a long time, there's just a much deeper global consensus around the importance of putting the underlying infrastructure for such things into place proactively.
All right. Well, thank you so much for the details of that latest loan worth $200 million for the impoverished. Ahmed, keep well. Ahmed Saeed of the Asian Development Bank.
Thank you very much.